It is no longer a rumor. I want to be governor of Edo State, and I believe I will be the governor of Edo State. The election is in September, isn't it? And all I can tell you is that there is time enough for a serious-minded person.
Are you prepared for this? How long have you been preparing to be governor of Edo State?
Since I was born. Since I was 6 years old, I always knew.
But this never surfaced in any of your write-ups.
That is not true. That's because people do not pay attention to the way I write about politics. Take books like Taking Nigeria Seriously. If you read Taking Nigeria Seriously from the beginning to the end, or you take When Does a Civil War Come to an End, you will know this is a mind consumed by what to do and how to do it about Nigerian politics. Lagos is where I take as the Archimedean point from which I have done everything since I was 19 years old. It is still my favorite city in the world, and I can tell you, if I had to run as a governor, this would have been my preferred state. I have big dreams about how to turn Lagos into, just name it, anything. But Benin is a city I have dreamt about from as early as I can remember, which is to say, anybody who has come to grips with the history of that city will know that it is a standpoint from which you can literally change Africa. When I talk about changing Africa, I mean, I don't want to be like those governors who, because they have tarred one road from one village to another, begin to assume that they have done great things. I don't want to be a governor who is remembered for tarring roads between one village and another. That's a job for local governments. I mean, take the whole city and remember that people built Dubai and built Singapore. Why should you be scrambling on the ground, playing the game of vulcanizer when you can be a proper engineer?
Well, under what party are you planning to come out now? Is it APC or PDP or a new party altogether?
Shouldn't you wait for me to read that narrative to that point where you get to know? I mean, take a look at it. Between the PDP and the APC, you have exactly the same party. Goodluck became a president, his party abandoned him. Buhari, even before he became a president, had abandoned his party. Both of them are equally handicapped. They are handicapped exactly in the same way. And I can assure you, one even managed with his technocrats and special commissions to provide answers that he could not run with. Buhari does not have the answers to run with.
We are well aware of the fact that in Nigeria, to run for any political office is quite expensive.
You are a writer. On you. In fact, that is precisely why some people are feeling comfortable. They think that because I am a poet, I would never be able to raise the kind of money required to win an election. But that is precisely where the surprise will come for them. I'm going to depend on all Nigerians, including you. Anybody who can give me 1,000 to 5,000 naira will be joining those 3 million Nigerians who will sponsor my campaign. They will sponsor this campaign. And I'm not, when I say that, I'm not feeling any shyness, because I know they will. If there are godfathers who can put money behind it, they are welcome. But Nigerians will sponsor my campaign. Wait for it.